These are my confessions. Just when I thought I said all I can say, my chick on the side says she got one on the way. These are my confessions. Man, I'm thrown and I don't know what to do. I guess I gotta keep all two of my confessions.
Stupid. The Arcadia confession pages are stupid. Because woman up or man up and just tell what you feel to other people. Don't do it behind the URL or tinyurl.com. It's stupid. It's just like form spraying. I mean, why? What advantage do you get out of hurting other people when you can't even show your face? Well, what's the point? If you like someone, ask them out.
I mean, I think the one good thing about it is that it gets students excited. Like, if we could get that kind of excitement for other pages and events at Arcadia, I think it shows that we're willing to rally around something. It's just maybe around different things, more positive things. I mean, because there are positive things about it. I have seen some genuine compliments, but I think these are things you should say to someone's face. Like, if you think one of your friends is really nice, like, shouting them out on the page is nice, but just tell them.
Whenever someone has to get something out and just, like, might be complaining or saying something bad about someone else on campus, other people step in to, like, try and make them understand. So I like that, and it brings some understanding to school. There are a lot of times like where you want to say something nice about a person, but you just feel like it's awkward. But if you can just like compliment someone on Secret Admirers, just give them that little boost. Or it's like if you have that one friend that you know needs the boost, then you can just give it to them and then they can feel special for a day. Feeling special is awesome.
Someone wants to find out why I could uncall the page, right? Which I would love to find out who said it. Maybe.
I think most of it's made up. I think that when you're anonymous, you can say anything that you want. And there's really no way to prove whether these things have happened or not. But if some of these things are true, they're quite shocking, and I'm really embarrassed to go to school with some of these people because some of them are really bad.
And if they do have secrets, everybody already knows them. Because what are we, like, 2000? The only one that I like is, I think it's kind of cute, is the Admirers one. That was pretty cute. But the Confessions page, it's like, I've actually never met one. Like, another fun fact.
I think the most ratchet thing I saw on that page was the RA who said this girl was a virgin, took her virginity, and then made her walk back to her dorm by herself out in the cold. I was like, who is this RA so I can slap them in their face? Some of the other ones were like, a lot of people here apparently like to like masturbate on like when their roommates are in the room or like have sex with their roommate in the room. And it makes me happy that I was a commuter for the first 2 years.
I think it's just a good way for people to just have fun, make some small talk, have some discussions. Other than that, I don't think they're doing anything wrong. I don't like the fact that people are trying to reach out about like suicides or sexual assaults, like that they shut that down and like put that to the last kind of thing. That upset me because if you're going to do something about people trying to open up from an anonymous spectrum, at least take all range of things because that's going to be someone that can be an outlet for a good.
Some people have been talking about some really serious problems on the Confessions page and also the Secret Admirers page, and other people in the university have like helped them talk about it and stuff like that. And I believe like the person who's running the Confessions page is like making an email so people can like email him and he helps them. It's like some kind of Dr. Phil anonymous thing.
One of the moderators and I decided to email address called arcadiauconfessions.com. And it was on Gmail. And it was essentially, we had four other moderators that would listen to these people who were obviously going through some really like, critical moments. We stressed this as a last resort, and we didn't give them any direct advice. Like, without saying, your first option should be, because some of the posts were suicide. Your first option would be contact suicide hotline. Your second option should be just go to someone and talk to them and cancel. Because we're only students. We're not qualified to run this kind of thing. We can certainly give you a shoulder to cry on, but beyond that, we just weren't equipped for that. But I think it was a good thing because it showed that people actually had issues that they weren't addressing or didn't feel comfortable addressing other people with. And given their anonymity, they kind of felt safe confessing to certain things that are just probably weighing them down. I can't even imagine that much. is there bad stuff on the site? And so we try to moderate that the best we can. But when you have so many people posting, it becomes sort of a daunting task. But I think for everything that's bad, someone's able to express themselves and could feel in a certain way that they never felt comfortable expressing themselves. And that's why I think it's a good deal. People have their issues with the page, but the main intention was, actually, as you say, I believe the other moderators have posted as well, is that the intent was to say, actually, like, be honest about Arcadia, but not be, like, derogative as some of the posts had been.
At first, it was just, like, funny, just, like, random-ass stories that you think would happen here, but you're not sure, and then you laugh at them, but then it kind of turned into, like, Suicide Watch and Pregnancy Pact and shit like that, so. Yeah, I don't know, it lost its steam quickly, in my opinion.
Ooh, it's kind of getting to be like the Harlem Shake. It's not lasting long.
We're not 8 years old, okay? Why would you want to be a secret admirer? If you want someone to feel good, just tell them. It's flattering. If they say no, they don't like you, whatever, get over it. But if people ask each other on a date, it's flattering. It's flattering. Asking to bone is not flattering. Yeah, let me demonstrate. Rose?
Oh, hi!
I think you're a swell gal. I would love to take you to the movies and maybe dinner afterwards.
Let me consider, because that is so flattering, Alex.
So regardless if you say no, you're still flattered, right? Because it's a compliment?
Well, yes, that you are showing interest in me.
Now this is what the confessions page does.
Hey!
Hey, girl. Hey, girl. I just want to rub your neck.
I just want to lick your
earlobe. Are you into feet?
No.
A fetish. You know, you kind of maybe want to, you know, I'm just thinking that you maybe want to suck my dick in the bathroom. Oh.